In this lesson, we're going to venture beyond just using the $W selector as an API, and we're going to import some more APIs into our code and actually create a different type of experience. So there's APIs beyond $W and the page elements. So for example, we have different verticals like Wix stores, Wix bookings, and other APIs you can interact with like animations and Wix window that don't require some type of vertical. So in this lesson, we're gonna take this deep dive with Wix window, and we're going to create a promo code experience for our STEM courses that we were just working with. So if we go back to our STEM program page, we're going to offer a new thing for our students that want a percentage off for their courses that they're going to take. So we're going to go back to the API reference and see how we can import some of these APIs into our code. Let's go back to Velo Help, API reference, and we'll open this up. So let's go beyond $W, and we're going to go to Wix window. So you see there's plenty of APIs here to use. In some of our other courses, we'll go into way more detail about how to use these APIs. Some of them require front-end experience. Some of them require back-end experience. But right now, we're going to show you some user-friendly approaches to using these APIs. So we'll open up Wix window on the bottom here. And you notice in the introduction, we have something a little bit different with the syntax. We have an import function here as well at the top. And we're going to import Wix window into our functions here. So you'll see that there's a lot of other examples that you could use. And we're going to focus here on copy to clipboard. So with Wix window, we're going to use the copy to clipboard function. And this function copies text to the site visitor's clipboard. So the function copies a specified text, and you can put that specified text as a static value right here within the function itself. So let's break down the code a little bit here on the side. So first we import Wix window, and then we use the Wix window API's copy to clipboard function, and we put the text that we want here. So this would be where we're going to place our promo code because we're never going to move it, right? This is going to stay static. Then we also use dot then to return a promise after that this is copied. So when this is copied, we're going to have some other type of event happen. So you can do this when you want to change the text of a button or have something else happen as this is clicked. We also do have this error handling here so that if an error does occur, we can display some type of message or even have some other type of alternative scenario if an error does happen. So we're going to recreate the same experience that we have right here in the API reference in our website. So we're back in the editor, and what we're going to do is import Wix window. So first at the top of the code, before our onReady function, we're going to import our API. So just make sure that when you're using an import statement and there's nothing above it, this is the first thing that should be in your code. So we'll import Wix window, and it becomes idle. That's because we haven't used this API yet or any functions within. So let's move up our code panel a bit here. And we're going to create a function outside of this onReady function just because I like functional programming. I think it's just a lot easier for me to organize my code. We're going to create a function called copy to clipboard. And inside this function, we're going to use the Wix window API. But before we start to use this API, let's recreate our experience here on the page. And we're going to drag and drop a box. And we'll change the color just so it fits the design. We'll change out the size too. We'll also bring in a button. Change the color of this button to match us. Back to that blue that we like. And we'll even change out the text of the button. So we'll change this to copy. We'll even bring in some text as well. So we'll bring in this heading right here. And we'll type in whatever random promo code we want. So I'll just use like a 6-digit or 6-character promo code. So let's just say F7, capital L, M, X, 2. All right, something real random. But we're gonna use the same code later on within our editor as well. So let's just drag and drop. Let's get this ready to go. So again, we're gonna use this same code within our code panel because we wanna use this later. So we'll drag this over, change it to design. And we also wanna change the ID of these buttons and the different elements there because we want to make sure we know exactly what we're using. So we're gonna change this button from button 13 to copy button. And we'll change this text to promo code. And let's even add something else in here just to make our visitors understand what they're about to get into. So we'll have this here, it's gonna say promo code. We'll change out the color of this text to black. Cool. And we'll leave this like this. And what we'll do now is since we have this button here for the copy button, we need to create an event handler just so that when we click this button, we're able to copy this same exact promo code we have right here. So let's just click this promo code and copy it in our clipboard for right now so that when we write this code now, we can just easily use it. So within our copy to clipboard function, I'm going to use the wix-window API, but first I need to create this event handler so that when I do click the button, I can copy the text. So what I'm going to do is create an event handler for this button. So we'll select it with $W. And that is our copy button. Copy button dot on click. And when we click this button, we're going to use the Wix window API so that we can copy the exact text that we have in the promo code there. So because we imported Wix window, we'll see already here in the autofill, it says Wix window. We do Wix window dot copy to clipboard. And copy to clipboard is looking for the exact text. So remember we have this promo code here. And we're going to put this in quotes because it's a string or text. That's the data type that it's looking for. So we'll copy our promo code right here. And that should be ready to go. But we also want to make it so that if I do click the button, when the promise is returned, I want this button to change from copy the label to copied so my user knows that the button has been clicked and they can have that like type of satisfying experience knowing that something actually happened, right? Because if I leave it the way it is right now, for example, if I go to preview mode and I click copy, nothing happens to the button. But I'm definitely copying this promo code right now. So go back to the editor and I'm just gonna show you right here. If I go below and I do Command V because I'm on a Mac, you'll see that the promo code has been copied, but I wasn't sure if it was copied or not. So let's return a promise that's gonna change the text or the label of that button. So right below, we're gonna use dot then. We're going to use dot then to return a promise so that when we actually use this callback, we could get the resolution for this exact thing that we want to return. So within dot then, going to go here. And inside of dot then, we want to change the label of our button, right? So the label of our button is going to be changed from copy to copied. So what we'll do now is we're going to take the same exact copy button and use $W to select it and then change the label of it. So $W, copy button, dot label, which is a property of the button element. And this label is going to be looking for a string or a text. And we're going to change this to copied, just so our user understands that when they click the button, something actually happened. Next, what we'll do is we're going to create an error handler just so that if something was to happen to our copy function, we are able to understand that an error did happen, and we can have some type of alternative case or maybe a message that lets us know that it failed. So a way for us to give a message that lets us know if it failed is by using console log to test. Console.log, and we can put this in text, failure. Failure to copy. Cool. Or we can just simply go error. So now in our copy to clipboard function, you notice that it's idle. That's because we didn't put it inside of our onReady function, or we haven't invoked it anywhere else. So let's just put it inside of our onReady function. Copy to clipboard. And let's test this out now. So now when we click the button, we should be able to see a change in the label of the button. And on top of that, we should be able to copy and paste our new promo code that we have here. So we have copy. And you notice the button has changed now to copied. So we know that it got copied. And we'll go back to the editor now just to see what the promo code looks like. And I'm just going to use some comments. So with JavaScript, to create a comment is by using two slashes here, forward slashes. And I'm going to copy right here my promo code. So look, our promo code's already ready to go, and I can get a discount now on my new courses. So this in this lesson, we learned how to go above and beyond just using $W to select page elements and use functions to manipulate them. Now we can use actual Wix APIs that are built in for you to create even more custom functionality and experiences for your site visitors. You know, there's plenty of verticals to use, like Wix stores, bookings, events that have APIs already built in. And there's other cool ones like animations, HTTP functions for you to connect to third-party services, you name it. The API reference is filled with different detailed information about all the APIs to use within Wix. And then on top of that, you have the forum and documentation where you can see our community talking about it and even see some examples from us on the documentation page. Well, that concludes our journey together. We've covered everything from using the API reference, creating experiences with elements, and then also adding events and responding to them. So there's so much more to cover within using Velo by Wix. So that's why we have some other courses for you, like the backend, frontend, and working with repeaters. So you can check out some more of these resources in the link below.